So hello everyone, I'm Ravi Chaudhary. I'll be talking about monocular vision aided autonomous UAV navigation in indoor corridor environments. This comes under the topic unmanned vehicles. So in the past few decades, autonomous navigation of UAVs with collision avoidance has been a key area of research in the field of robotics and computer vision. It has enormous applications both in public and private sectors, such as aerial surveillance, search and rescue movements, military applications, disaster management, intelligent transportation, and much more. So talking about UAV navigation basically consists of two parts, that is outdoor navigation and indoor navigation. In case of outdoor navigation, the UAVs have inbuilt GPS modules that assist in the navigation of the UAV, whereas in case of indoor navigation, the GPS precision is very low or the GPS signal is not at all present. So in order to counter this problem, proximity sensors and LiDARs are used for the autonomous navigation. But the problem with proximity sensors and LiDARs is that they are very high power consuming devices and also heavy weight. Also, you need multiple LiDARs or proximity sensors in order to achieve autonomous navigation indoors. Vision sensors are light, compact and low power consuming devices. So coming to the proposed system in this paper, it proposes a monocular vision aided method to navigate a UAV safely inside corridor environments. So the entire process is basically divided into two stages. First is avoid collisions with the sidewalls, and the second is detect and avoid the obstacles that come in front of the UAV. So the proposed system architecture comprises two main components. First is the UAV itself, and the second is the vision module. So the communication between the vision module and the UAV is achieved using a local area network and using the ROS interface. ROS is nothing but robot operating system, a customized operating system made for robotic applications. So the first stage involves finding the vanishing point, and the second stage involves estimating the depth of the obstacles that come in front of the UAV. These will be discussed in detail in the upcoming slides. So this is the block diagram of the entire algorithm. So on the right side of the screen is the UAV module with a front camera placed on it. So a constant video feed is sent to the ground control station, and not the entire video but frame by frame processing takes place on the ground control station. Initially the frame received is converted into grayscale, and a Gaussian blur is applied on the same image in order to remove any sort of noise present in it. Then canny edge detection algorithm is applied in order to detect edges. Further, half-line transform is applied in order to find the edges of our interest, and the intersecting point of these edges gives us the vanishing point. So the edges here are basically the intersection point of the ceiling and the sidewalls of the corridor wherever the UAV is navigating. So once the vanishing point is estimated, yaw, pitch and roll coordinates are sent to the UAV from the PID controller that is present on the UAV itself. And if vanishing point is not found, then further the upcoming frames are processed and the entire process repeats again. So discussing vanishing point estimation in detail, vanishing point is a point present at infinity, basically the point where parallel lines intersect or tend to intersect. So for vanishing point estimation, initially we convert the input RGB image to grayscale equivalent, and then to reduce the noise we apply Gaussian blur on it. Further, we use canny edge detection on the top one third and the bottom one third part of the image, followed by half-line transform to detect the edges. So this is a better picture of the vanishing point estimation. The figure shown A, B and C. So P is the vanishing point estimated by the algorithm. Now in order to achieve safe collision free navigation of the UAV, your vanishing point should lie within these two blue vertical lines which are shown in the figure. So as shown in the first figure, the vanishing point is well within the blue line limits, but in the figure B, the vanishing point lies on the right side of the blue line. So your drone has to roll on the left side in order to bring the P point inside the blue vertical lines. Similarly, in figure C, the P points lie to the left, that is the vanishing point that lies to the left of the blue lines. So in order to achieve autonomous navigation avoiding the collision with the sidewalls, you need to bring this P point inside the two vertical blue lines. So you give a right roll to your UAV. So this is now coming over to frontal collision avoidance. So this is a simple approach based on the concept that as soon as the distance between the focal plane and the object increases, the area covered by the image formed in the video frame increases. So as soon as the object moves near to the camera, the area percentage area occupied by this object in the frame increases. So taking the ratio of the area occupied by the object in two consecutive frames at a certain interval gives you an estimation of the depth of the image, that is how far the obstacle is from the UAV. So this is the image processing output of the algorithm. Initially corridor, then you convert the image into grayscale, apply Kenny edge detection algorithm on it, further you apply half line transform and other filters in order to get the desired edges, then you take averaging of all the lines present in order to get two lines intersecting at the vanishing point. Once the vanishing point is obtained, you can decide whether to roll your drone to the left or right depending on the position of the vanishing point. Your vanishing points should lie within the two vertical lines which are shown here in the pink color. So the proposed vision assistance scheme for autonomously navigating UAV in a corridor environment has a success rate of 70 to 80%, as demonstrated in this paper. The scheme has been tested under different corridor environments and it is found to be very robust in terms of no collision rate, full flight rate and obstacle avoidance rate. As the algorithm uses only video extracted from the front camera, it is a good candidate for UAVs with power and weight constraints. Also, this autonomous navigation approach can be used in environments where human intervention is not at all possible. So this is the reference. This paper was published in the year 2019. Under the IEEE Transactions on Sustainable Computing, Volume 4, Number 1. Thank you.